Hello and welcome to another L'amour in Christ video. Today I'm going to be answering a question that I get a lot about. How do you deal with insecurities and find your identity in Christ? So let's go ahead and talk about that today.
God is the Father that I never knew I had.
God simply is everything.
God is faithful.
God is my strength.
God is always the answer.
God is a promise keeper.
God is very powerful.
God is my wonderful counselor.
God is compassionate to me.
God is perfect.
Love. God is love. You may have a lot of questions about your walk with God, so let's talk about it. All right, so you chose to stick around. I'm Kytia L'amour, and who has not dealt with being insecure? I know that I have had a lot of self-confidence issues in the past, probably starting as a teenager, which a lot of us do. We're like, we're not cool enough, we're not smart enough, we don't look good enough, we don't dress cool enough, like all those things come into play. However, probably since I've been later in my 20s, I kind of had a realization that there's only one me, and like seriously, there's only one me, and God made me on purpose. So how do we know that? Let's go ahead and look at one of my favorite scriptures of all time, Jeremiah 29:11. You've probably heard it too. Let's go ahead and read along. Jeremiah 29:11 says, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not harm you, plans to give you a hope and a future." Plans. In one scripture, it says plans 3 times. And there's also the scripture about him knitting us together in our mother's womb. That is very specific. That is very detailed. He cares about the details. Why we were born, where we were born, when we were born, all of that stuff. So God cares about us and he cares about the details of our life. But I understand that there can be some times where it seems like we're worthless, nobody likes us, we'll never be good enough. So how do you defeat those lies? Because some of you have messaged me and you're like, well, I try to give myself a pep talk, I try to speak the truth over myself, but it kind of just feels like I'm lying to myself and I don't know if I really believe it. And a lot of times these insecurities may manifest when we've been bullied, or if we've grown up in a household where people don't appreciate you or tell you a lot of great things about yourself, and especially in certain households where they feel like, oh, I don't want you to be prideful, so let me cut you down, you know, a couple pegs so that you don't have to deal with pride. We already know you're smart, we already know you're pretty, we already know you can dance, like all that stuff, but I want you to be humble. And some parents just don't know. They don't know how to instill values and also confidence in their children. And that's something I'm even learning, because my daughter, she's very outgoing, she's very intelligent and everything, and sometimes she gets really down on herself because she wants to be the best, like at everything. She wants to learn things faster, she wants to be the best at it, and I have to continue to kind of help her to feel better, but also let her know, like, it's not the point to be the best. It's not the point to be the smartest, the prettiest, the one who's the best at gymnastics, the one who's fastest. Like, all of those things don't matter. It's about who you are as a person. So I build her up as far as who she is uniquely in Christ and let her know, like, God made her a certain way. So for me, that's something that my mom helped me a lot through teenage years, even though I did compare myself a lot to other kids. Like, I could come home and my mom could tell me and talk to me about those things that I was feeling. But as you get older and you graduate from high school, you're on your own, then you have another wave of, like, you're not making enough money, you don't have the right job, you don't have a boyfriend, like all of these comparisons that people say this is what you should live up to. By the way, who made that up? Like, who made that up, that this is what you should be doing, this is who you should be around, this is how much money you should be making? Like, there's a lot of things that people have put on themselves or put on other people, and it's just like, there's really no blueprint to success like that. The only success I've ever known is following the Lord wholeheartedly, working on my walk with him. And so the video that I did a while ago about how I found YouTube success and how I understood what my purpose was, that was a fundamental part in me actually healing from a lot of insecurities and me understanding who I was and not to lord myself over people to be better than them, but really just to say like who I am is enough. Like it really is enough. And God had to work with me on that, because even after you're an adult, then you get married, then you have kids, and it's like you're not a good enough mom. And like there's just always voices coming at you through media, through friends, through family, through all of this stuff. But we have to recognize that the most important thing is to pursue the Lord and to ask Him, why did you make me? Why did you make Kytia on this earth? I am not a mistake, I know that, but why did you make me? What is my purpose and my calling? And I feel like that in and of itself is something that broke me free from a lot of the expectations that I put on myself, expectations that other people put on me, because I'm like, look, there's only one creator, there's only one being who put me together, who knows the ins and outs, and has a whole future planned for me. So how about I seek Him and ask Him what is what? What is it all about? And there's even people who I've talked to before when I was like in my early 20s, and they're like, you know, after I turned 30, like that's when I really felt like I was myself. I really felt like I was coming into my own. And I didn't really understand that until I did turn 30. Now I'm 33. And throughout these past few years, it's kind of like you get over, well, at least for me, like I had to just be so done with the garbage and the nonsense and what I felt the pressures of life were. And I was just like, you know what? There's got to be more to this than just always being anxious, always being scared, always feeling like I gotta keep up and I can never keep up no matter what I do. And then when I am at this level, then there's people trying to put me down like, oh, you think you better and you think you can do this. So it's like, you can't win with people, you just can't. But with the Lord, all things are possible. So that's something that I would just like encourage you guys in, is asking the Lord why you're made. Not just saying, okay, I'm reading the Bible, I'm praying, I'm praising and worshiping, like those are amazing tools, but developing an intimate relationship with God as He is your creator and asking Him specific questions and just looking at your life, like what are you good at? What are you passionate about? What are your hobbies? What is it that wakes you up in the morning and you're like, I can't wait to do this? It could be working on cars. It could be solving math problems and accounting. It could be painting. It could be really anything. It could be like helping kids, like you're a preschool teacher and everything. So what is it that drives you? Those are the things that God has put in you, as long as it's not hurting other people and something that is against what the Bible says, because sometimes we like to do stuff that is just not good for us. But as believers, we're meant to deny ourselves in those ways. But as far as what is good and what is something that's helping the world and being in alignment with the Word of God, those are the things that we should focus on. What are we drawn to in that? So for me, for example, like me, ever since high school, I entered into a program called multimedia. And then I ended up going to college for television production. And right now I'm sitting in a room. I have a camera on a tripod with a microphone hooked up, and I edit my stuff. And I like doing this. Like, sometimes it is like, wow, this is a lot. Sometimes I don't feel like it, but all in all, I love what I'm doing right now. I love being a mom. I love being a wife. I love being there for my family. I love going outside and doing fun things and going on adventures and traveling. So those things are what I'm focused on, because I'm like, God, if these are the things that you put in me, then they must be a part of my purpose. Okay, if I love to travel, that must be a part of my calling. If I love being around family, discussing deep topics and issues and what's going on in the world, that must be a part of my calling. If people come to me for advice about dating and I love being able to minister to them and help them out, that must be a part of my purpose. So think about the things, instead of what you don't have, instead of what you don't look like, instead of what you're not doing, think about the things that are good about you. What are things that people tell you? Like, are they coming to you for advice a lot? Are they asking you for help and you're like, I can't wait to help. I love helping people. I've actually met people like that where they literally love helping people. They're like, you want me to help you move? You want me to help you like redecorate? You want me to help you go grocery shopping? Like, they literally love service. And so those are some kind of like some pointers in getting you headed in the right direction, because if we're always thinking about how we're not living up to certain people's standards, like we're never ever ever going to feel like we're good enough. But if we're like, God, these are certain desires you've put in me, these are certain gifts that you've put in me, help me to know what this is all for. And start pursuing that. Start looking, if you're in high school, start thinking about colleges that have to do with what you love to do. If you're looking for a job, look for work that has something in line with what you love to do. If you're thinking about community and hanging out, look for places and people who support and like the same things that you like. Because even for me, I've gone to Bible study groups before, and I've talked about my small group when I was right before I got married, being in Hawaii, and there was other Bible studies, other small groups I went to, but for some reason, like, I just never felt connected. I just never felt like we meshed together well. But then you'll know when you find your people, where it's like, oh, we're interested in the same things. Like, we love God. That's the most important thing. We're following the Lord, but we're also interested in fashion. We also love, you know, doing acting and stuff. Like, it was like my people. So, like, finding those activities and those hobbies and those jobs and careers and that schooling to support the things that you already know are inside of you. And I promise you, if you keep focusing on that, there may still be people who are like, you ain't nothing and you ain't never gonna be nothing and you ugly. You know, there's still gonna be people who say those things, but when you know that you're right in line with God's will for you, like, there's this supernatural peace and freedom and boldness and courage and confidence that comes out. I promise you, I've lived it. I've seen other people close to me live that, where they're just like, you can't tell me nothing. Like, I know where I'm supposed to be. I know what I'm supposed to be doing, and that is fulfilling to me. You will never have true fulfillment outside of God's will for you, outside of His purpose for you. So if you're wondering about finding your identity in Christ and getting rid of insecurities, pursue God with everything that is in you and watch everything fall away. Getting rid of toxic friendships, getting rid of toxic behaviors, because when you're really following the Lord, you're not going to want to do that. You're going to crave that intimacy, and you're going to crave that time with Him, and you're going to crave knowing that you're on the right path, and it's going to change your life. It's going to turn things all the way around. So let's go ahead and pray about that so that we can keep this covered in God's blessing. Thank you, Jesus, so much for the plan that you have for us. Thank you for being with us, for the Holy Spirit that is inside of us, for helping us to know that we have a plan for our future that you've given us. Help those who are really wondering, I don't even know what I'm supposed to do. I don't even know what I'm good at. Please just rise up in them those thoughts and that discernment of like, no, this is what you were created for. This is why you can't stop thinking about that. This is why this gets you excited at the beginning of the day. This is what you're meant to do. Please help them to pursue that with everything that is in them, just to pursue the gifts, the talents that you have for them, that every single other thing will be broken off of their life. Anything holding them back, I just break it in the name of Jesus. Any deception, any false teaching, anything that is just causing them to be in any kind of bondage, please break it off in the name of Jesus. Help them to have clear thinking right now in Jesus' name. Help them to know what is your voice. What are you calling them to do? What were they made for? What are the things that you love about them that you put inside of them? And help that to even cause a domino effect where other people around them who are also insecure, and that's maybe why they bully them, help that to cause a domino effect where even they are like, what do you have? What did you do? Because you are transformed. You are completely different than the shy, insecure person I used to know. Tell me, what is your secret? And help this to be something that causes a testimony in their life and helps other people to be set free as well. And I thank you, God, that you are marvelous and amazing and wonderful and true, and you're going to do what you said you were going to do, what you promised in your word, what you said you were going to do for your children. You will lift us up and you will help us to run this race strong. And I pray this in Jesus' name, amen. All right, you guys, that's all I have for today. Thank you so much for watching. If you have any other questions, or if you even have your own advice on how to find your identity in God and how that was something that you've done, please leave that below, because I'm sure that would encourage many, many people. Also, if you want to keep seeing videos like this about what God is doing in my life, what He's teaching me, you can go ahead and subscribe to this channel. And don't forget to turn on that notification, click on that notification bell so that you'll get it notified when I upload. And also, if you want to support this channel and keep videos like this coming, you can encourage me in the comments. I love your sweet messages that you send me privately and publicly. Also, your prayers are always, 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 always appreciated. Thank you so much for that. And financially, there's two ways you can do that as well. You can buy my merchandise. I have designs on laptop cases, phone cases, t-shirts, wall art, all kinds of stuff. I have that in a link down below. And the last way is to donate. If you want to send a secure PayPal donation, I have a link below in the description box, and any amount helps. I love you guys, and I will see you in my next video. Until then, be blessed. Bye. Oh. Is this too bright?
I think so.
Yeah, that's better. That's better.
Welcome to the show of your life.
What? That was weird. Okay. What if it wasn't recording the whole time? Mm.